Now, the type of problem that we would be doing is analyzing reflection coefficients, fields, or impedances at any location in region number 1, 2, or 3. To do this, we would be given the thickness of each region, the frequency, and its electrical properties. Using table 7.1, we would be able to calculate alpha, beta, eta, and lambda. On exams, I typically calculate portions of these for you because you don't have enough time on an exam to just punch your calculator for all of the equations. So, for instance, for this case, the values that were left out were when sigma equals 0, our attenuation constant is always 0, as shown here. The value of lambda is found using 2 pi divided by beta. Here are the values of beta, so here are the values of lambda given. The only one that we generally don't need is region number 3. The other constant that you need is eta, and eta for the case of air, which is shown right here, is 377 ohms. So the first thing you do is you calculate all of your constants. The next thing that you do is you define your origins, region 1, 2, and 3 is shown here. The origin for most of your regions is on the right-hand side, origin 1, origin 2, but on your last region, origin number 3 is on the left-hand side. That's always the case. If we define the positive z direction going this way, we'll define this point as minus d2 and a point out here as minus d1. So define your origins as shown. Then there are two major rules. One of them is the characteristic impedance. The characteristic impedance is constant across a boundary. Remember that the characteristic impedance is defined as the total electric divided by the total magnetic. It's a ratio. If this ratio were not constant across the boundary, there'd have to be some kind of explosion. So we can say that the characteristic impedance given in ohms jumps the boundary. The ohms are equal on either side. The other thing that we know is if we want to move from the right side to the left, that's the same thing on a Smith chart as rotating towards the generator. So these are the two things that we're going to do in order to analyze the reflection coefficients and impedances within our model. The first thing we do is begin on the right-hand side. We know that the characteristic impedance, which is a ratio of the incident electric to the incident magnetic at region number 03, so this is like a definition, that's given. That was given to be 84.3. And in this region, there's a wave propagating in the forward direction, an incident wave, but there is not a reflected wave coming back in the other direction. So in this region only, we can say that eta 3 is equal to z 3, and that's equal to the total electric divided by the total magnetic. Now since we know the impedance at 03, we know that the ohms jump the boundary, so we also know the impedance at 02. So z 2 at 02 is equal to Z3 at 03, which is eta 3. Now here we are at 02, and we would like next to go over to D2. What we need to do is get onto the Smith chart and rotate towards the generator. Now to get onto the Smith chart, the next thing we have to do is normalize. We are in region number 2. The characteristic impedance there is eta 2, so in order to normalize and get onto the Smith chart, we're going to divide by eta 2. When we do this, the value that we get, eta 3 is 84.3, eta 2 is 41.9 plus 1.16, I got that number messed up, and what we end up is 2 minus j 0.06, which is what we're going to plot on the Smith chart next. Notice that here we had ohms divided by ohms, so here we just end up with a ratio that has no units.